Hi everybody, my name's Isla. Many of you all know me. I run BritYarn, an online yarn shop which specialises in British wool. I often do periscopes, but I thought I would give this a try, so this could be a podcast. Who knows, it's a little bit scary. I do apologise if I waffle, and do say a lot as well, I apologise. So basically, first I'll just introduce myself. Like I say, my name's Isla. You can find BritYarn on the website at www.britYarn.co.uk. We're on Instagram, Twitter, and we've got a Ravelry group all under BritYarn, and obviously also on this YouTube channel as well. So please, if you like us, please subscribe. It'd be great. I will still be doing the periscopes. I just thought that the periscopes, the quality just wasn't good enough. So when I'm trying to show you yarn, it was just a little bit, kept on being fuzzy and stuff. So I will still do them because I love having the interaction in the chat. But I just thought, we'll give this a go. So here we are. So this is BritYarn. This is where we're sitting. I hope the lighting and sound is okay. It's a bit of a dull day. It's spitting about with rain now here in North Lincolnshire on this Tuesday afternoon. So that's the introductions. Oh, I should also mention we've also got a blog. The blog is separate to the website, but on the blog is where I basically do blog interviews with different people. So this month I've interviewed Victoria from Eden Cottage Yarns. We have our yarn of the month on there, which is also Eden Cottage Yarns Milburn 4-ply. So all sorts of stuff on there goes on there, and all that, like the new, anything new happens on the blog. But like I said, we also post on Twitter and Instagram for like the instant kind of news. So that is that's introductions, I think, over and done with. So we'll go on to some news. First up, we've got some new yarns. On Monday the 24th of August, we launched some new autumn and winter yarns. So we've got two new Aran weights, a chunky and a super chunky. So I'm going to show you those now. So first up on the Arans, we've got the Aran available in two different shades. And this is from Chillia Valley Alpacas. They're based in Devon. So this is the Aran weight, 100% alpaca. As you'd imagine, it's ridiculously soft. So that's the Aran. And we've also got it in. So they're the two Aran colours. Now they're undyed, they're natural. So these colours literally have just come from, obviously alpacas come in many different shades, their fleeces do. So like I said, they're grown, the alpacas live on the farm, on Chia Valley's farm down in Devon. And then it just travels, the fleece is clipped, and it just travels a short way to Cornwall to be spun into this gorgeous yarn. See that? So that's that one. So that's the Aran weight one. I'll just pop that down to one side. Then the other Aran weight we've got it in this colour, which is like a mist colour, I think it is. See if I've written down the colour name, because I haven't. Yeah, this is mist, and it is a proper misty. It's a very, very, very pale grey. But with obviously that hint of the creaminess still in there. And this one and the, this is the chunky one, but this one, the Storm Cloud, these are 70% alpaca and 30% Shetland Lambswool. And the Shetland sheep are also from their farm. And so all the animals live in Devon. So that's that. So like I said, I mean, I was thinking when I saw these, I did a swatch. I'll show you my swatch. So there's the swatch. Now we will be getting in the chunky colours, chunky weight yarn, we will be getting this colour that I'm holding in the swatch and this colour, but it's still being made at the moment. So in the chunky weight, we've just got the grey, which I have to say, I think it's an absolutely stunning grey. Now when I saw these, when I inquired about their yarn, obviously they sent me some samples through, which is great, which is why I was able to, you know, sort of do a bit of swatching. Because I do like to, whenever I try and get new yarn in, I do always try and like to, you know, knit with it as far as possible. And if I can, I like to try and knit an actual object rather than a square, but this I only had 10 grams with, so it made a very nice swatch. So yeah, so I was thinking these are like perfect for winter hats, winter cowls, things like Claire Devine's Lapsang. I thought would be absolutely perfect for, like I say, just very, very, very soft. Yeah, really soft. Love it, love it, love it, love it. So these are in the shop now. So like I say, the ones like I say got the Aran and the Chunky. The Aran is available in 100% alpaca and obviously the 70-30, and the Chunky is just available in the 70% alpaca, 30% Shetland. So that is those. Like I say, I'll just see if we can show you that again. It's not that much of a. It is. It has obviously got an alpacary halo. There we go. But like I think that would just be just absolutely amazing, just so soft. It's lovely, love it to bits. So that is those, and then the Super Chunky yarn is a name many of you will know. This is Erika Knight Maxi Wool. It's 100%, it's a mixed blend of wool. We've got it in four colours at the moment. There's a whole raft of shades available, but I was going to start with four shades at the moment and see how things go, and if people like this wool, then obviously, you know, I'll do what I've done previously with other yarns. I'll put a picture on Instagram and ask people, you know, what shade should I get in next, because it's so hard sometimes, you know, you have like, you know, 20-30 shades. Unfortunately, I can't stock them all, I haven't got that much space, but I will always, you know, if I'm not sure, I've just generally, what I've done, like I say, in the past is just popped a picture on Instagram and said, guys, look, what do you want? So like I said, this is really nice. The colour's not quite true there. There's always problems with greens. This is a much more, it looks looking a bit blue there on the screen, but it is a proper, it's a lovely nice green. So this knits up really nicely, I have to say. It's not completely smoothly spun. You can see it's got a bit of a loose ply there. But basically I'll show a fin FO in this, but I just did a, I didn't know what to do with the rest of my scheme when I did my object. But that is the, that's it knitted up. It just makes a very nice fabric. So again, I'm thinking, you know, like probably like, I can imagine like a really fab, chunky, super chunky jumper. And again, your hats, your scarves, if you really wanted like quick gift knits, you know, for Christmas or birthdays, then this will just be, I think, pretty cool. Excuse, I was running out of yarn there. Let me show you that way. It's much better. It's much tidier. But yeah, I think it's a lovely yarn. So like I said, that's in the shop as well. That's Erika Knight's Maxi Wool. And, you know, like I say, we've got the four shades at the moment, but we'll be looking to increase those over the years. So that's new yarns, literally just received today. Not going to talk about them today because otherwise we'll be here all day and all night. Just got some lovely Knitting Goddess, additional Knitting Goddess yarns in. We've always stocked Knitting Goddess ever since we launched back in June. But what we've just sort of, again, gradually building up the range. So I've just got some multicolour, it's like a variegated Brit sock. And I've also got one of her new yarns. It's a Falklands Merino Sparkly DK yarn. So again, that's pretty special. But they're all there on the in the shop. So if you want to take a look. Many of you will know if you watched my Periscope video, which I also uploaded to YouTube a few weeks ago. We got some new bags in the shop. I'll just reach across. These are our new canvas gusseted bags. I won't dwell too long on these because obviously you'd have seen these before, but these are massive. These are like huge bags. You can see they're really strong. And they've got our logo, which obviously you're seeing backwards there. That's good fun. So that's that. And we do have some other project bags in the shop. We've got some small and medium. And they're like the Japanese nut bags. So if you've seen them in the shop and you're not entirely sure how they work, then this is how they work. So basically, you just hang them on your arm. Or what I do downstairs in my knitting chair, it's got like arms in it, and I just tuck them onto my arm, onto the arms of my chair. But like I say, I've got these in the small and in the medium sizes. So that's that. So so that's all the new goodies. Obviously new yarn, new bags. Other news is we are just over halfway on the Scollay Along Cal. This is what we're jointly hosting. BritYarn is jointly hosting it with the Louise of KnitBritish podcast. If you don't follow Louise, I definitely recommend you do. She's been podcasting now for a couple of years, all about British yarn, British producers, British dyers. She's got a fantastic accent. I could just sit and listen to her forever. Sounds a bit weird, that just, doesn't it? But she's lovely. So yeah, definitely if you don't follow Louise or not a member of her Ravelry forum, definitely check out KnitBritish. But we started last month a Cal, a knit along, and we're all knitting the Scollay cardigan by Carrie Westerman. And Carrie designed this last year, I think it was, in British yarn, with all that sort of that in mind. And so yeah, so we cast on, we had a virtual cast on party over on Instagram, Twitter and Ravelry, which is good fun. Didn't do any knitting because obviously it's pretty hard trying to obviously knit and Instagram and tweet and do forum messages all at the same time. But we, yeah, that was really good fun. We hit the midway point last Friday. And then we had another like little party again on Instagram, Twitter and Ravelry. So you might have seen, if you're not part of the knit along, but you do follow me on those areas, then you probably would have seen all sorts of random tweets and retweets. But it's absolutely, so there's already some finished objects already in the KnitBritish FO thread. So that's fab. I think there was about 9 or 10 already. We've also got a couple of people starting their second cardigan. And I think there was also one lady who was thinking about doing their second, but doing it as a jumper, which I thought was really pretty fab. So yeah, we're halfway. So if you're interested in joining us, please join us. It finishes on the 25th of September, so there's still plenty of time to knit a cardigan. It's done in DK weight yarn. It's done in DK weight yarn, so it's a pretty quick knit. And I'll show you mine in a moment under the work in progress section. So yeah, that's really good. We're alternating the chat between the two different Ravelry groups. So 1 week it is in the BritYarn group, and then it goes on tour to the KnitBritish group where it stays a week, and then it jumps. Oops, I just lost my pile of things. Not good. And then so we're alternating backwards and forwards. And the plan is, those of us that are able to attend Yarndale on the Saturday, the, I think it's the 26th of September, off the top of my head. But we're all going to wear our Scollays, and we're all going to meet up and basically have a bit of a snap and a bit of a knit, sit outside if we can, hopefully, and just have a bit of a knit. So yeah, join us. If you're too busy at the moment, it's got too many whips, then check out the design, because it is a really pretty cardigan. And I think what's become really evident quite quickly as people have finished is that it doesn't matter what your shape or size is, it just looks great on everybody. Lots done in British yarns. There was one that was finished yesterday that was done in hand-spun Shetland, which, yeah, I think, yeah, hats off with the old hand-spun, because it's really, truly stunning. But yeah, there's been Scollays in black as West Country Tweed. We've got quite a few in the Air Valley, DK, which is West Yorkshire Spinners. And there's also, I think, at least one in the West Yorkshire Spinners Jacob, which again is, it's really nice to see people trying different yarns. We've also got some multicoloured ones as well, which is great because the actual patterns are solid. It's a solid colour. But quite a few people have had a bit of a rummage in the stash and kind of thought, what can I do here? And they've pulled off some really pretty cool things. So check it out. Like I say, if you're not interested in joining the knit along, then just, like I say, have a look in the FO thread, which is in the KnitBritish group, because there's some good work gone off there, definitely. So, sort of looking at my notes. So next then, we'll talk about finished objects. I won't always have FOs. Don't often have the time at the moment to knit that much. So, but yeah, we've got a few here today. One of them is a really old one, but I've not blogged about it, so I kind of thought it was okay to talk about it. So my first one, I'm wearing it. This is my On the Edge shawl. Now this pattern is by Joy McMillan, and Joy is the lady behind the Knitting Goddess yarns. So not only does she dye amazing yarn, she also does some patterns. This shawl was originally designed for her mini skeins, which we also sell, but I didn't really have any mini skeins of my own at the time, and I was after a shawl design to use the BritYarn colourway in the yarns from the yarns from the plain Mobberly 4-ply. So that's the Mobberly is it's the colours in the what we stock are exclusively dyed for us by Nick from Yarns of the Plain. And there's some semi-solids, there's some with quite a long sort of colour change in it, and then there's Blackpool Illuminations, which is quite, as you'd imagine from the name, it's, you know, quite colourful. So yeah, so I cast on this, and I'll wind it for you. It's really easy knitting. It's just perfect knitting. Basically start at one end and you just work and you just increase one each time. I might have got that the wrong way around. But yeah, you just increase one stitch each time and then you finish off with a picot bind off. Yeah, but I love this yarn. Obviously, I love this yarn. But I've also got a hat. When I first found out about Nick last year, before we launched, I purchased a skein of her yarn, of the Mobberly yarn of her, and I made a woolly worm head hat. So I knew what it was like. But it's a great yarn. It's a blend of Exmoor Blueface and alpaca. Now the Exmoor Blueface is a cross between the Exmoor Horn, I think it is, and the Blueface Leicester. So that gives you a bit of an idea there as to how it feels. And obviously then the little bit of alpaca in it just slightly changes it. But I think it's a really, I'm impressed with that. So like I said, it took me a little while to knit, because obviously, you know, doing different things. But it's just really easy. And I will definitely say it's a beginner pattern as well. So if you know somebody or maybe you're just starting out yourself, it is dead easy. There's no counting involved. There's some yarn overs, there's some, you know, increasing. No, there isn't any increasing. There's yarn overs and there's decreasing. But it's a dead easy pattern. And you could probably do it in pretty much any yarn. Obviously this is done in 4-ply, but if you wanted like a really big version, you could sort of maybe do it in DK. You could do it in a solid colourway. You could do it like this in a 2 colours. I think, honestly, it'd be a really good stash buster as well. You know, if you've got lots of like bits of sock yarn, that'd probably work well because obviously it's designed for mini skeins. So yeah, so that's my On the Edge shawl in my Yarns from the Plain Mobberly. My other FO, or one of my other FOs, is this. So this is in the Erika Knight Maxi wool. Like I said, I like to make things with the yarn before we stock it. You know, knitting a little square is fine if that's all I'm able to do. But if I can at all possible, I do like to, you know, sort of properly knit with it, block it, see how it goes. So this is a pattern called the Fourth Day Ear Warmer. It's a free pattern on Ravelry, and it's really effective. I'll try it on. I'm going to look a bit silly because I have to do all sorts of weird hair things when I do things like this. It's probably not the best look, I apologise. You get the idea though, don't you? But it covers the ears, which is obviously what I was after. And I wanted something like this for like dog walking. You know when it's windy, but it's not cold enough to wear like a big woolly hat. But this will just hopefully keep the hair kind of in place, and more importantly, keep my ears out, keep nice and warm. But yeah, it's a really nice yarn. Like I say, it's lovely and soft. And this pattern only used 42 grams of the Maxi wool. So, you know, if you're thinking about quick gift Christmas gifts, then you could get two of these out of one skein, which is pretty good going. I have got quite a big head, so you probably don't need maybe as much as 42 grams. It's a bit of a family trait, I'm afraid, big heads. I blame my dad. So that is another FO. Like I say, I excuse me, dodgy sewing up there, I apologise. But yeah, that's a fourth day ear warmer. Bit of a mess. And that's on Ravelry. So definitely recommend to check it out. So that's that. My other FO is an old FO, so I apologise, but it deserves being shouted about. Now, I'm not too sure how well you're going to be able to see this, because it's a tank top. But this is my Colossus tank top. It's in Eden Cottage Yarn's Milburn 4-ply, and it's one of the patterns in the Bletchley collection by Joanna Scrace. So I started this as part of an Eden Cottage Yarn's cowl, but I didn't finish it in time. I'm really, it was cables front and back, and I really am a very slow cable knitter, and it's in 4-ply, so you know. I finished it. It's lovely and soft. It's a blend of BFL and silk is the Milburn, so you can imagine it is definitely next to the skin soft. Without a shadow of a doubt. So I featured this actually in a blog post a couple of weeks ago, because the Bletchley collection, we featured it this month on the blog, so there's some pictures there. But yeah, that was another FO. I think I finished this sometime in July. It was before the Scollay along cow. So yeah, that's that. I like that. I did have to redo the armbands. I do have a tendency to cast off too tight, and in my determination to get it finished, I cast off the armbands and then tried it on, and yeah, watched my arms turn blue as it was cutting off the circulation. So I was mortified. It was one of these things that I either had to deal with it there and then and fix it, or I probably never would have worn it again. So I, yeah, just had to just get on with it and fix it. But it's done, I love it. It's got enough stretch in it as well, because obviously it's got the ribbing all the way up the side, so it has got quite a bit of stretch in it. So what I've been doing at the moment is wearing it with like a vest, and I have worn it with like a long sleeve t-shirt as well. But yeah, in the winter, probably be able to wear it with like a long sleeve blouse as well. That's what I was hoping. So yeah, so they're my three FOs. On the Edge, Colossus, and my ear warmer. So, on to work in progress, I suppose. A bit of a tea addict, I'm afraid. So, work in progress. Excuse me, while I lean across. First of all, then, is my cardigan for my knit along. So, this is Scollay cardigan. So, you can see it's done in reverse stocking stitch. And then it's got the lace detail and the sleeves. It's also got the same lace detail on the bottom. And then the lace detail, I'll show you on the back, is all around. So obviously this isn't finished yet, so it does need a good block. But that's that. So I just need to, let's have a look. I have done one button band. I just need to do buttonhole band and graft one of the underarms. I've done one underarm. That must be the one I've done. I just need to graft the other one. So I really like this cardigan. It is, the way it's been designed, and Carrie has included notes in the pattern. You can get the pattern, by the way, on Ravelry directly from Carrie, or if you prefer the paper copy, then you can get the paper copy from BritYarn. But yeah, I really like how it's designed. Basically, I've done it with a little bit of negative ease because I prefer my cardigans to be quite fitted, but the pattern is equally suitable for people who want a bit more positive ease. If you want something a bit more roomy, a bit more baggier, then it works either way. It's got a little bit of shaping in it. Quite a few people have asked about the shaping. It has got a little bit of shaping in it, but it's not that much. I think it's quite a gradual shape. So that is mine. So I really hope I can get that finished by the end of this week. And then, like I say, pick some buttons. And hopefully wear it at Yarndale. That'd be great. That is the plan. The yarn I've used is Blacker Yarns, and it's their Lyonesse DK. It's the Rose Quartz colourway. For those of you that don't know, it's a blend of 50% Corridale and 50% linen. So it makes a really nice summer cardigan. But I was working on it on Sunday outside and it got a little bit chilly. And it was just on my knees because obviously it's a decent size now. And I think the linen will keep it cool. But I'd also think it's going to be good. It's a bit of a contradiction, really, isn't it? But I think it'd be fine in the winter as well. I think it will be a warm cardigan. So that's that. So it'd be very nice to get that finished soon. Other things? This is in my woolen flower pouch, which I bought at Edinburgh Yarn Festival. These are my show-off socks. This yarn, sadly, is not British. I do try. So this is it's a free pattern on Ravelry. Like I said, it's a show off socks pattern by Anne Campbell, and it's just a slip stitch pattern. It's dead easy. So this yarn is from New Zealand, and it is a golden skein yarn. Basically, golden skein is a yarn club where they show you a picture, and they show three dyers each quarter a picture. And the dyer then, uses their own, inspiration from the pictures to dye up a unique colourway. Now, what I'm really hoping, it's been on their website for a long time. It's been on the Golden Skeins website for a long time. But they would keep the thing on the website is that they might be doing a British club. It's called, I can't remember what it's called now, but it's basically the distance from Land's End to John O'Groats is the name of the club. It's 837 miles club or something. So I'm stalking their website now because I really would love it if that came out, because I love the idea behind the golden skein, but like I say, I do try to buy British wherever possible. So that is my socks, they're my whips. Now this next pattern, there's not really much to show you this. I cast on because I was dying to cast it on, but then I didn't really get any further, so I've just done one repeat. This is Talavera by Amanda B. Collins. Now Amanda is also known as Owl Print Panda, so you might have come across her. She had a lovely store at Edinburgh Yarn Festival selling stitch markers, and she's also on Twitter and Instagram. So Amanda B. Collins or Owl Print Panda, depends on how you know her. But this is a pattern called Talavera. It was a pattern in the Summer Pom Pom magazine. And I don't know how well you're going to be able to make that out. Basically, it's just a summer top. It'll probably be next summer when I'll be finishing it. So like I say, you won't be able to see much on this because I've literally just done one pattern repeat. Now the yarn I'm using is Eden Cottage Yarn's BFL sock. Again, we stock it, but this colour in particular was from my stash. But yeah, we do have some lovely shades in stock. So yeah, there's not really much to see there. But basically, it's just a lacy sort of, and it's quite straight. It's designed to be worn, obviously, with it being lace with underneath things. So that is, that's that. Like I said, I'm hoping once my cardigan's finished, I'll be able to sort of make some real good progress in there. That's the plan. So in my Brit Yarn bag, little sheepy. This is my, I'm probably going to pronounce this wrong, Mayhee shawl. It's another Carrie Westerman design. You can tell I'm a huge fan of Carrie's. And this is, she released it maybe a couple of months ago. It's one of her newer patterns. Obviously not that much to show at the moment apart from a giant triangle. Basically this pattern is designed in the style of a Shetland hap. So those of you that did the hap along over in the KnitBritish group will be fully aware of haps and how they're constructed. So this is, like I say, you just knit a triangle with yarn overs at the end, and then you change direction, and then there's lots of lovely lace work that will come off in that direction. So I've got a good few more rows to do before I'm in a position to start the lace work. Now the yarn I'm using is a yarn I'm very, very proud about. It is the Lincoln Long Wool. Now I was born in Lincoln, so to be able to use local to me yarn is fantastic. So this is from the Risby Grange flock of Lincoln Long Wool sheep. I bought the yarn at Lincolnshire Show in June. So yeah, and what I didn't realise, and I need to look into this more, is this yarn was also spun in Lincolnshire. Now I was not aware until I was chatting to the ladies on the Lincoln Longwool stall that in Lincolnshire there was any spinning mills. I was quite surprised. But the sheep are massive, by the way. There were loads there. It was really great to see all the sheep. And if you, on my YouTube channel, if you look at the picture, on the sort of front of my YouTube channel, the sheep there is a Lincoln Long Wool in that picture. They're huge sheep, they're massive, really big sheep. And it was a Lincoln Long Wool that they crossed with the Merino, I think it was, to get the Corridale sheep many years ago. So I'm really excited to see how this blocks. It is a rustic yarn, what people would call a rustic yarn. So it's not the softest of yarns, but I think for what it was for, bear in mind it's like a Shetland hap, you know, these are meant to be hard wearing, you know, garments, not garments, accessories. And I also think once it's blocked, it's going to change amazingly. So yeah, so apart from my triangle, not much to show there. But I am so looking forward to getting onto the lace. I will obviously be using lifelines because, I'm quite renowned for mucking up lace work. So I will be using lots of lifelines and lots of stitch markers to break up the pattern. So my last work in progress, if you apologise because I haven't got this out, let me just rummage. Now this is some brioche. You can tell I've really not done much. Now this is a pattern called Lemon Difficult, and it's by Kate Atherley. Now what I didn't know, Kate is originally from the northwest of England and moved, I think she's in Canada now, but she's originally from the northwest. Now like I said, it's my first brioche. I have never done brioche before in my life. Brioche, by the way, not the bread, the knitting stitch. I'm using some stash yarn. For this, if you ever look at the pattern on Ravelry, you'll see the sample in Ravelry is using a black yarn with a really highly variegated bright rainbow coloured yarn. So what I've chosen is the cream yarn, you can see, that is Blacker Elegance. And then the darker yarn, you can see, is Crazy Zebra Ball. Again, that's deep stash yarn. I've had it for quite some time. And those of you that are familiar with Crazy Zebra Ball, It's a really long run of colours, sort of the gradients in it. So this is all, it's got greys. I'll show you. So yeah. So I think, like I said, this would be quite a subtle. So you'll always get the white or the cream, because that'll always stay consistent. But then the dark will just gradually change to the different colours in there. So yeah, so I knit on this, this stays upstairs actually in BritYarn. I just kind of, you know, sometimes when you just need to just sit and think and just to, you know, get your head together maybe. So I just do a few rows on that. So that is all my work in progresses. I have got one other work in progress, which I'm testing some yarn for BritYarn for. I'm using Claire Devine's Viella pattern. But obviously I can't show you that because I am going to stock the yarn for definite, but I'm going to keep it as a bit of a surprise. It's currently being dyed for us at the moment, so watch this space. I'm very excited. So I think last but not least, so I don't want to keep you too much longer because we've all got busy lives and we've all got lots of knitting, crocheting, spinning to do. I thought I'd have a bit of a chat about my trip recently to the British Wool Show. The British Wool Show was held in York on the 7th and 8th of August. It's in the York Auction Mart, which is like a cattle market. Not been to it before. I think originally it was held in Harrogate, I do believe. And I think this was the fifth year of it running, but due to, I think, for costs, they've moved it to the Auction Mart. It's a bit of a mixed bag, really, to be fair. I really enjoyed the show, to be fair. Like I say, York's not a million miles away from where I live, and I went with my best friend. It just seemed really quiet. And that made me really sad. It really did. And it was nice to walk around. There were loads of space because, I mean, you know, those of you that have been to some other shows and you know when it gets crammed, you know. But yeah, it was very quiet. And I spoke to quite a few of the stall holders and they were saying how quiet it was. The footfall just wasn't there, which was a shame because, you know, yes, there were some local stalls there, but there was also people like the Queen of Pearls who had travelled down from Glasgow. And that's a long way. It's a lot of money to spend to kind of then not get the footfall through. And it wasn't really that well advertised. I follow their Twitter feed. And I did see tweets and stuff, but there wasn't that much. And I didn't hear any press releases read out from any of the podcasters that I follow. So I'm kind of guessing there probably wasn't a press release either, which is disappointing because it's not, you know, I know these things take time. But it's just really important to, you know, get the word out. So yes, yeah, so I was a bit disappointed the fact that that it was really quiet. Like I said, it was on a Friday and Saturday, and I went on the Saturday. So I was a bit disappointed with that. But obviously, parking wasn't a problem. There were no queues. I pre-booked my tickets, mine and my best friend's tickets, so we just sort of went straight in. I also thought it was a little bit hard to navigate. Some of the other shows that I've been to at auction marts, you know, you're walking up and down the livestock aisles and the stores are in the pens themselves. But this show, it was a little bit more, you'd get some stores and then you wouldn't get any and then you'd have to kind of go around a corner and there'd be a few more and then it just seemed very spaced out, and like I said, a little bit hard to kind of think, oh, hang on a minute, are we going in the right direction? Not sure. But what I did see there were some really, really good stores. I was really pleased to see quite a lot of British yarn on offer. I was disappointed to see non-British yarn there. It was there, and for me, the British Wool Show, it's in its name really, isn't it? It should all be about British wool, British sheep breeds, British fibre. And also when I say British, I also do mean the Falklands. But there was definitely, and this is going to sound really snobbish and I don't mean to, but there was definitely acrylics there. there was definitely yarn that isn't, I wouldn't classify as British. Maybe it's had its boar band put on in Britain, but personally, that isn't British. So I was disappointed to see an element of non-British yarns there. But having said that, I did manage to buy a few things, obviously. So I will go on to show my goodies in a minute. I do want to mention there was a store that I follow this gentleman on Twitter. It's a gentleman called Peter Mawson. And Peter runs the High Farndale Farm. Now, because I follow him on Twitter, and on Twitter he's down as High Farndale Farm. Now, Peter keeps, just referring to my notes here to make sure I get the name right, white-faced woodland sheep. Now, they're a rare breed, they're on the at-risk register from what I recall, and he keeps them both for their, I think primarily for meat, to be fair, because I know on Twitter he does tweet the fact that he does these lamb boxes of meat, which he'll get delivered to you. But he was selling his fleeces. Now, I don't spin. I do have an interesting learning, but I don't spin. But my best friend does spin. And we spent quite a lot of time chatting to him. He was a really fab guy to talk to, actually. Extremely passionate about his animals, farming, and I suppose the future of sheep farming, which obviously is at the forefront of a lot of people's minds. He had his fleeces there. They were unprocessed. They were literally just off the sheep and then rolled up and popped into brown bags. And he was selling them for, might have been £10. Might be wrong there. But it was just really good to see him. So if you're interested in purchasing fleece, I don't know if he sold them all now, because obviously it was a little while ago. But yeah, definitely follow him on Twitter. I do know, I think he did actually quite well. It was really nice to chat to him, because my best friend did buy a fleece, and we went back after we'd finished looking around the other stores, and I think he'd got like maybe 5 or 6 left, which was really good to see, because obviously if he'd have gone to the British Wool Marketing Board with him, he probably would have got, well, maybe 50p, probably not even that, for his fleeces. So that was really good to see, the interest there. So other things I bought, I spent quite a long time chatting to the ladies on this stall, and this is by the, let me just check the label actually, to get it right. Yeah, it's the National Angora Club. Okay, and they've got their own, they keep the animals, they got had a couple of rabbits on the show. Lovely ladies, they were so passionate about their animals, their welfare of their animals, and basically just promoting you know, this as a fibre. So that was really lovely to chat to. So I bought a skein, and this was 50% Angora and 50% Blueface Leicester. Obviously the Blueface Leicester just stabilises it a bit, because obviously Angora otherwise, you know, it'd be too puffy. And you can see it has got quite a few sort of loose hairs there. So yeah, but that was really nice to chat to them, lovely ladies. And they basically, it is a charity. They're not a business, it was a charity. And like I said, it was all just about promoting the rabbits, and about, you know, keeping them healthy and everything, which was really good to hear. So that was that purchase. I did buy some spinning equipment. Now, I bought this from Lowlands Legacy. It's a company based in Holland. So these people have travelled all the way from Holland over here. And I saw, it was somebody on Twitter actually on the Friday, tweeted about they'd bought this spinning tool, and I was like, wow. And this person had not spun before and produced some pretty impressive stuff. So I had my eyes open and I bought one of these. I am going on the Jolie's Kitchen Retreat in February next year, and I am on the drop spindle class, but I've been dying to learn to spin for ages. So yeah, so I'm pretty chuffed. It's thick and thin. I've got all sorts of thicknesses going off there. But basically, you sort of you tease off your fleece, and I won't demonstrate because I'm rubbish at it. And you literally just spin it like a rattle. Like that. You can also ply with it. So I bought some Falklands, I think it's like a mixed thing. I don't think it's merino. But it didn't come with a label, I'm afraid. It just came. So I bought some of that at the British Wool Show. Because I wanted to. It did come with some quite pretty fibre. But I didn't really want to start ruining nice stuff. So, yeah. So I bought... There's quite a bit there. Quite a bit of weight. So once I've spun up half of it, then I will spin up the other half and then have a go at applying them together and end up with some weird thick and thin. But, you know, you've got to start somewhere. But I'm enjoying that. So my other two... I did buy some... I thought just in case I do... get the bug, we'll stock up on fibre. So yeah, so that is Falkland tops. Now one thing I need to learn is what the different things are. So I understand that's called a braid, but I might be wrong. Like I said, my spinning knowledge is weak, but I'm willing to learn. So my last purchases was from the Queen of Pearls. I mentioned them just previously. They, I don't know the lady's name, and I really should have checked before I started this, actually. Basically, it's a yarn shop in Glasgow, and the lady who runs the yarn shop also dyes her own yarn. And I thought, I really enjoyed chatting to her, actually. I also bought a pattern, and one of her own patterns, I bought a pattern from her as well. But really enjoyed chatting to her about the show and also about her yarns. She had a really lovely display, and she'd got like all her skeins hung up, so that was really cool. And what was really fab, obviously for somebody like me, is she'd dyed up specially for the show a range of different bases that she wouldn't, from what I understand anyway, she wouldn't necessarily normally stock. So this is Dorset Horn. It's quite like all the blues on that. So this is going to be like a hat, I'm fairly sure. It's a little bit crisp, but I don't mind that. That's not an issue for me. So yes, that's a Dorset Horn. But yeah, I was just so impressed that she had, obviously she'd fetched a normal range with her as well. She had a lot of West Yorkshire Spinners yarns. But I was just like, you know when you want to hug somebody and you just kind of go, that's brilliant, awesome. So it was really good. She'd got Dorset on, she'd got other less common bases as well. And she'd also got, I'm guessing this is probably one of her standard ones. This is BFL. Citadel Sock, it's called, 100% BFL. And I don't really have any yarns with that kind of, those sort of colours. So this will probably be socks, I think. But I thought that was pretty cool. So that is the British Wool Show. Like I say, it was an interesting... I'm glad I went. I really am glad I went. I generally did have a really good day. They had the... I can't remember what it's called now. Is it the Sheep Show? The Sheep Showman? Not sure. But he was great. I thought he was really educational for children, really funny, and hopefully would get them interested in sheep and how sheep have developed and their fibre. But also, you know, from an adult point of view, it was, you know, it wasn't aimed specifically at children, and he was hilarious. He was really funny, so that was good to see. I don't know if that show will happen again next year. I'd definitely say check it out. If it does happen again, it's in York and you're not a million miles away from York, it's definitely worth a go. But yeah, it's just needs to be busier. It'd be great if it was busier. Right, I have talked for nearly 50 minutes. I apologise if I have waffled. I don't intend to edit this in any way. What you see here is what you get. I'm not an airs and graces kind of person. You know, this is me. This is how I am. Like I said, I don't intend to start editing it out and, you know, making it glossy, because It's not me. So I still will be doing the periscopes. So, and as I always have done in the past, I always put the periscopes onto YouTube anyway. And I will be doing a periscope about the new yarns. So look out for that. And yeah, so follow me on Instagram, Twitter. Obviously, we've got the Ravelry forum. I forgot to tell you, talk about Ravelry. I'm pointing there. I'm sorry. we're also doing a little giveaway until the end of the month in the forum. I realised when I got the new canvas shopping bags through that our logo sheep doesn't have a name. So we're doing a bit of a giveaway. So if you can basically choose a name, it's one entry per person. It'd be lovely if you could join the forum as well. We've already got quite a lot of members there already, which is brilliant. But yeah, if you can think of a name for our sheep, that'd be great. The short list of names will be going to the illustrator, Melly M. Clark, who designed our logos, and she's going to pick from the shortlist. So check us out on Ravelry. I'd love you if you could maybe subscribe to this YouTube channel. That'd be fantastic. See you around. Check out the shop. We're building up our range all the time. Obviously, we're still quite a new business, so it's, you know, can't do everything all at once, but we are getting in new yarns all the time. Thank you ever so much for watching. It's been lovely. I enjoyed it. I was a bit apprehensive, I must admit. You can probably tell at the beginning I was a little bit nervous, but yeah, thank you very much for watching, and see you again soon. Bye.